Today is June 25th, as you can see by pictures behind me. It's been a long night for fire crews and people in Lake Tahoe. This wildfire has been burning in the Angora Resort area off North Upper Truckee Road since yesterday afternoon. Let's get you caught up on the very latest. The fire has eaten through more than 2,000 acres since beginning yesterday afternoon. 220 homes gone. That number could climb to 300. Flames forced more than 1,000 people from their homes, from resorts, and from campgrounds. Investigators say the cause is human, but they haven't been able to pinpoint just how the fire started or exactly where. All right, let's get to our all-important live team coverage this morning. KCRA3's Brian Hickey joins us in South Lake Tahoe. Brian?
And Walt, the thing that's the most amazing about this fire this morning is the intensity at which the flames were burning, even in the cool, humid morning hours. The flames reaching some 60 to 70 feet in the air. Some of that backfires by fire crews trying to protect South Lake Tahoe, the town. As you drive up Lake Tahoe Boulevard, you're heading right into the fire, and you can see the plume of smoke that still remains behind us here this morning from the fire activity that has occurred overnight. At this point, fire crews say the number of homes lost, 220, will likely climb. There are some areas that they just can't get into.
A cool and humid morning in South Lake Tahoe, yet the Angora fire rages through the forest.
This is just definitely the craziest thing I've ever seen up here. Oh my God, it looks like an inferno is eating up the whole high school.
Hundreds of homes have been lost. Hundreds more lay in the fire's path. It's been a sleepless night for those living on the front line.
We've just got everything ready to load in the car. I just asked him if we need to evacuate, and he says, I can't promise you anything. So I got to go get my kid out of bed and get my car loaded.
Everybody knew it was going to happen sometime. But
so what are you doing right now?
I'm going to try and take my trailer someplace and we'll see what happens.
While residents prepare to leave, crews are building their own defenses. This crew from Sacramento assigned to protect homes.
We choose the houses that we think are salvageable. We prepare them for a firefight and then just hang out, stand by.
And you can see the crew from Sacramento, crews from far and wide coming to here and aid in this fire. There has been a disaster declaration, and 22 federal strike teams are now on their way to this fire. Each of those teams made up of about 10 to 12 firefighters. So a lot of resources on the way already, more than 600 firefighters here. They're going to get 9 helicopters and 2 air tankers just as soon as they can on these flames. Now that the sun is up, hopefully those air tankers will be up there supporting those fire crews that are on the ground. And you saw the video, very intense fire activity up there that they're battling from the surface, and it's a very big fight for them up there. They're going to have a briefing right now for the fire officials at 6 a.m. We'll get some more information out of that as they try to piece things together this morning and come up with a plan of attack before it gets hot and dry once again out here in South Lake Tahoe. Walt, back to you.